Mic check. Can you hear me? Let me do a test real quick. See if you can hear me. If you can hear me, someone like below say, I can hear you. Let me see. Let me see if you can hear me, Dave. Can you hear me? Let me see here. All right, if you can, check below. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Okay, so we're doing a quick check here to see if you can hear me. Make sure you can hear me loud and clear. You can hear me. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I'm trying to see if you can hear me. Maybe you can hear me, maybe you can't. Look right below. Can you hear me? Let me see here. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. I'm trying to see if anybody can hear me out there. Let me hit something over here. Let me see if you can hear myself. I'm checking to see if you can hear me, ladies and gentlemen. Give us just 1 second. Dun, 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 dun. I'm checking to see if you can hear me. Okay, so I'm starting to get some messages saying, yes, we can hear you. All right, thanks a lot, Tawana. You can hear me. All right, CC Carter says, you can hear me. Thank you so much. Now I'm going to check in. Now I'm going to check in to see what happened to my guest, Dave Anderson. Dave Anderson should be right back on here in just a moment. But I couldn't hear him. This is Trevor. Let me tell him I'm live. Hey, man. We're live, as you know, probably. Oh, because I couldn't see it below. So Dave jumped off, but everyone can hear me. All right. This is Trevor. Let me know that we can hear me from one black CEO to another. I'm going to check in with Dave because I don't see him. I see he was on a second ago. And it looks like he went down. So let me see here. Okay. This is what happens when you're like real time, ladies and gentlemen, you're real time. So let me reach out to Dave and see if he had a little trouble connecting. 1 second, everyone. You guys are eavesdropping on this conversation, by the way. Okay, let me see what's going on. Hey, man, I was just checking to see if I could see your name, but I don't see your face on here.
Yeah, I don't know why this stupid thing is acting like it doesn't want to let my camera be great.
Well, you know, check it, see if that's your camera, see if it'll allow you to do it on your phone. Maybe that's the issue there, I'm thinking.
Okay. All right, well, give me 2 seconds, let me work this out, and I'll hit you right back.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to give him 2 seconds to jump on, and then we'll be hearing from none other than the man, the myth, the legend himself, none other than the Dave Anderson. And you guys are going to be really cool because Dave Anderson, you're going to find out, is the business editor of allhiphop.com. Look, they got 2 million plus views. They got thousands of subscribers on YouTube, and he's the first director of social media, both Radio 1 and iHeartMedia. You're gonna love him. We're going to have a conversation from one black CEO to another. It's going to be an incredible conversation. He's working through a few things there to see, one, if he can get his camera up, because sometimes that happens. And then secondly, if not, we're going to give him a call in. But I do want to say hello to Tawana Ignite Jackson. Thanks a lot, Tawana, for letting me know you can hear me. CC H. Cardwell, thanks a lot. Let me know you can hear me. Alexandra Johnson, we're coming to Sacramento. We're coming to Sacramento. It's going to be live. Kelly Thomas, thank you so much for letting me know you can hear me. Jocina Newson, welcome. And my man, Kevin, we're coming to Little Rock, Arkansas. We're going to be in the house. Can't wait. Denise Daniels, welcome aboard, by the way. As everyone is coming aboard, you know, sometimes you have technical difficulties, right? Sometimes things happen. You find yourself in a situation where you have to kind of slow down so you can kind of make sure everything is working. Just to share a quick story about that. And if you've ever been in a position where you had to make a change on the spot, where you had to pivot where you had one plan, but it just didn't go the way you wanted to, and you had to change, just look right below, and just put hashtag stay the course. Just put that right below. Like a little encouragement from my man Dave Anderson out there. He's fighting to get on. I see him coming and then going and then coming and then going. Go ahead right below and put hashtag stay the course. Just put hashtag stay the course. We're gonna pay it forward. We're gonna recognize Dave Anderson for all that he's doing to fight to get on here. Look, I had the same situation today. And this is why I want you to put hashtag stay the course. Just put that right below. Hashtag stay the course. Look, I was in a situation today. Had nothing to do with what we're gonna talk about, but from one black CEO to another, I'm focusing on my health, right? And I'm not perfect. And I have a personal trainer that I meet with. Her name is Devon. And I meet Devon at 6 a.m. in the morning. That's kind of early for me, by the way, over at our Sport and Health Club here in Washington, D.C. on Capitol Heights. Now, here's the situation. Before I have to meet with her, like the night before, I'm always wondering what the workout's going to be like because she always has a different plan for us. Well, I showed up this morning. Maybe this is you. This is where I'm going with hashtag stay the course. Hey, Tawana, thanks a lot for sharing that. Hashtag stay the course. Brian Boone, thanks a lot. Hashtag stay the course. Dave's fighting to get on here. You see him fighting to get on here. Hashtag stay the course. Thanks a lot, sir. I appreciate that. Hey, Shanika, how you doing? Hashtag stay the course. Absolutely. So I met my personal trainer, right? And I go over to her this morning. And I go to her. And I go to her with a confession. Now, I pay her a lot of money, right? And I'm like, look, I got to confess with you. I had these strawberry shortcake ice cream that I just love. And they come six in a pack. And I said, last night I ate three of them, like in a row. And I also had, and if you know me anything about this, I mean, I love I love sour patch little candies, right? Little Sour Patch gummies and so forth. I love those things. I got a bag last night and I told her, I said, look, I bought this bag, but here's what I did. I threw out all the yellow gummy bears and all of the green ones. And instead what I did is I just focused on the red ones. And I was like, so I feel so bad. I had so much sugar. And this was like last night, about 11 o'clock at night. Do you know what she told me? Today is a new day. She said, we start all over again today, Shay. Let's just get going today. Don't worry about last night. And I said, wow. And so when you say hashtag stay the course, some of you in your business, maybe you found yourself in that exact situation. Like, why do we do stupid stuff like that anyway? Like, why would I eat three strawberry shortcake ice creams in a row? And you would think I could tell myself to stop, right? And I couldn't. And then I proceeded to stop by Harris Teeter, which I do at night. And I decided to buy the Sour Patch cookies. I mean, Sour Patch gummy bears, which I love, by the way. And I ate them. And I knew better. Have you ever been in a situation where you knew not to do something, but you did it anyway? Now, here's the purpose of having an accountability coach. I was able to check in with the person. They didn't beat me up. They didn't try to say you're a bad person. They didn't try to say, well, why did you do that? Explain why you do it. Let's go back and revisit why you did it. No. What I liked about her, she said, you know what? Start where you are. It's a new day. And you can move forward. And what I thought in that moment was, you know what? It's time to stay the course. And in our business, in our life, in our relationships, in our health, sometimes we find ourselves in that exact situation. Look, if that's ever been you, I'm going to call David. David said he's sending me something, said he's coming on. He says, bro, I'm coming on in a minute. Okay. So David Anderson, he's working on it. He's going to be here. Now, sometimes we find ourselves in our relationship. I know I have in a health situation and we're off track. And today we're all going to get back on track. Now, I'm going to ask Dave Anderson. He's known as the business bully, right? He's written several books. He's an amazing individual, has a humongous reach. You probably know him at allhiphop.com. Super fantastic, right? I'm going to ask him, what do you do to get back on track and how do you stay on track? Look, if you're out there right now and you found yourself where you've been off track, you found yourself where you had to kind of start all over again. You found yourself where you had to reach down inside of you and pull out what I call that inner winner that said, you know what? I can push a little further. I can work a little harder. I can start over again. My past does not equal my future. Look, someone right now, if you're out there and you hear me, look, one black CEO to another, no matter what your revenue is this month, no matter how your relationships are going, no matter what's going on in your health, right below, just type these words. Just type these words for me. Type these words. And then I'm going to recognize LaShonda and folks that are out there. But type these words. My past does not equal my future. Write that down and put your, not my, your past does not equal your future. Jot that down. Your past does not equal your future. Someone just do me a favor. Put that right below. Just put that right below. So if you're going through some difficult times right now, or if things are going very well for you right now, here's what I know. The best is yet to come. Now, we're going to have a conversation, right? Dave's trying to get on there. I'm going to check in with him in just a second. But you, let's look right below and put your past does not equal your future. Hashtag stay the course. And you stay the course. And you know what? The magic happens all by itself. Now, I see you out there. Alexander Johnson says, my past does not equal my future. I believe you. Chiquita says, my past does not equal my future. I believe you. Leslie Jones Berry says, your past does not equal your future. CC Caldwell Miller, look, if you see that out there, just hit the like button. Just pay it forward to someone else. Alexander Johnson says, my past does not equal my future. Kevin, Coach You Well Williams, my man is out there, says, my past does not equal my future. Hey, Edwards, good to see you. My past does equal my future. LaShonda, welcome aboard. Brian Boone, glad you could hear me. Thanks where you are. I certainly appreciate it. And all of you out there. Hey, Mark Downs from D.C. in the house. You see, I'm representing today. Now I don't want to tell my man on the other side to do that because, you know, Dave, he might go put his Temple shirt on. I got to watch it. He might go put on Philly or something. I'm representing, Mark. I'm representing in the house. All right, let me go over to Leslie, and then let me come over to my man out there who's out there. I'm going to do a mic check to see if I can even hear the, not A, but the Dave Anderson. Dave Anderson, mic check.
Check, one, two, my mic sounds nice.
Okay, I don't hear you. Hold on, let me hit the button. Let me try it again. All right, say something.
My mic sounds nice.
Okay, I don't hear. All right, hold on, let me make sure you're not on.
You're killing me.
Okay, I hear you now. I hear you.
About to say.
But you're coming through, hold on. Can you? There you go. Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
I can hear you too. Look, it's working, my man. Look. I'm gonna do a formal introduction of you, man. But look, Dave, if you can, for those folks that are listening, those entrepreneurs from one black CEO to another, what do you say to the person that finds themselves off track and they gotta get back on track? And what are some things they can do, man? You are the business bully. We're gonna get into that right now. You've written several books. Don't worry, we're going to get into that. I know that you've done some amazing things. You're the business editor of allhiphop.com. You're a rock star. But before I get into the 2 million views that you have, the subscribers you have on YouTube and all the things that you do,
right,
what do you say to that person out there that held out there? They hung in there with us during this time of us getting this system up and going. What do you say, my man?
First and foremost, thank you for your patience. I am not responsible for the technical difficulties. It just happens sometimes. But when you get stuck, you have to remember, this is not how it's supposed to end. You know, my grandmother always said that, you know, it's all going to work itself out in the end. If it ain't all right, then it's not the end. You know, and so even when it seems like it sucks, you know, it's all about building you up. I mean, think about it. If you watch, I'm a Philadelphian, so I'm going to give you a Rocky reference. Rocky Balboa gets his ass kicked for six movies. Mm-hmm. And you know, he always comes back at the end and wins, you know, with one exception. So that's the thing. If there's nobody there, if there's no bad guy, if there's no adversity, if there is no struggle, then you will never appreciate what it is to make it happen. You know, you hold on to those stories. Think about, you know, I mean, if I was as great as Shay Brown, I'd probably say, well, you know what? I can remember a time when, you know, my kids wanted this and I might not have been able to get it to them, you know, so I hold on to that now that I'm a big, super successful, super rock star like I am, being Shay Brown in D.C., chilling and making it happen, flying coast to coast, you know, snapping necks and cashing checks. You know, so you hold on to those times because those are the times when you're forged in fire, you know, and it's not always easy. I struggle every day. You know, and I'm nowhere near the struggle I was 7 years ago. So I'll take this struggle over being homeless and washing up in the gas station sink any day of the week.
Look, man, I hear you loud and clear. And look, I know you mentioned Rocky because you're from Philadelphia. Look, who is your favorite movie character, Dave? I just have nothing to do. We're going to talk one black CEO to another. But who is your favorite movie character and why that kind of inspires you, that kind of gets you going, my man? Is it Rocky or who is it?
No.
And those folks that are listening, who is your favorite movie character? Put it below and why. Who is your favorite movie character? Go ahead, Dave. Talk to me.
Movie character is Clubber Lang from Rocky III, and I'll tell you why. Rocky one, Rocky fought Apollo. Rocky two, Apollo wanted to settle the score. Rocky three, Rocky is fighting all of these people who don't have anything. You know, he's just knocking them down, knocking them out there, cherry picking fights. And all of a sudden, there's this dude in a small apartment, and he's working, and he's grinding, and he's got a mohawk, and he's angry, and his teeth are gritting, and he's running. He don't have cameras flashing in his face. He's got no money, but he knows how to fight. And he's going to take these two hands and the skills that God gave him, and he's going to catch you slipping. And so all of a sudden, Clubber Lang shows up to the art museum steps on the day the Rocky statue was dedicated. And he says, "Hey, man, you've been running from it. You're a paper champion. I'll take you right now." Then he turns to Adrian and says, "Hey, woman, why don't you come over to my apartment tonight? I'm going to show you what a real man does. You've been ducking me. I'll take you out too, old man." He did not care about the lights. He didn't care about the glitz. He didn't care about the family. All he cared about was being the champion. Too many of us, once we get that big six-figure deal, or we get, you know, that speaking engagement we've been looking for, or that contract we've been waiting, or that promotion at our job, if that's your thing, we think that it's cool, and we start to coast, then we get soft. My whole thing with Clubber Lang is that he reminds you what it is to be hungry. You don't need all that flesh. You need to use these and use this, and then psych out your opponent and then knock them down. So my favorite movie character is anything Mr. T does, but specifically Clubber Lang, thus the mohawk.
Thus the mohawk. And it's still, look, you know, my favorite character, and I see some folks are putting out, someone said The Rock for what he does on the screen and off the screen. Nolita, I see you out there, says lots of laughs. Someone says, "I have a throwback for you, Leroy Green." Leroy Green from The Last Dragon.
Daddy Green's Pizza, that's The Last Dragon.
You got that one? I didn't catch that. Oh, man.
Leroy Green, Blues Leroy, biting bullets with his teeth.
Hey. Your favorite movie character, and why? Look, my favorite movie character, believe it or not, is going to be this guy here, Captain America, right? And it's not because of what he does when he became a superhero. It's all the work and training he had to do to get him to that place. It's where he started from, and understand that where he started from. Now, he didn't plan that, but he was open to new possibilities. He was open to doing something different. And then once he was able to get the gift or get the power, he decided to do it for something good. And those folks that are out there, we're going to talk about some of the business basics, some of the things you can do in your business from one black CEO to another that can help you have the superpower. Now, you could be from Mr. T. I love that. I love him, by the way. I love him. Could be Captain America. It could be whoever it is. But think about it. You showed up today. And part of life is showing up. And the promise that we have, myself and Dave, is that this is going to be a good use of your time. And you're going to walk away with one idea that you can use immediately to help you in your business. In fact, I'm going to ask David. Look, we don't have no script right away. We just thought we'd step back. No, he and I were having a conversation. I said, "Hey, man, can we have this conversation with some people that want to eavesdrop on the conversation? They want to view what's going on?" He said, "Shake, turn the camera on. Let's do it." So here we are. Dave,
yeah.
As you think about it, what's one of the challenges? You work with business owners, man. You're out there. You're the business bully. What's one of the challenges that black CEOs are seeing in the marketplace? And what's one solution you would offer? Look, you do a lot. So you got to frame the conversation for the folks. But a challenge and then a solution that you would offer that they can take away on this call. Look, get your paper. Get your pen. If you have a challenge out there and you want to maybe ask the question, look right below while Dave is talking and say, "Look, here's my challenge." And I'm going to ask Dave if he has an idea for you. As we do that, I will recognize Linda Blake. Helen, she's a diary of mad of black women. That's what she likes, for her perseverance after her trials and tribulations. Toya Hayes says, "Hey, Dave. Hey, Shay." She's on here. Nate says, "Lots of laughs." She's here. Nalita says, "Stay focused and keep hungry. Stay alive. Keep doing what you're doing." All right, man. Over to you. One business challenge. And what's the solution that you would offer to the person watching right now?
In the course of a year, I'll probably have consults with about 300 business owners. And the one thing that I hear once I tell them what they could possibly be is this: "Well, Mr. Anderson, I feel like I should be able to, but I just don't." And I'm like, "Excuse me?" And they're like, "But I feel," and I'm like, "What? Say, I feel." "Oh, so your feelings." So what happens is they have feelings about what people will think. They have feelings about what their friends will say. They have to be a failure or not. They have feelings about what their spouse is going to do because they haven't had those hard conversations yet. Mm. And so what winds up happening is they get stuck on feelings that may never, ever happen. We tend to worry. We create a self-fulfilling prophecy dealing with anxiety because we're so concerned about what someone might say or what someone might think or what someone might do or if they're going to be there when we fall. And my whole thing is this. You need to take your feelings, all right? And I need you to just put them in your back pocket. Shove them down in there. And if you got a button on that back pocket, you lock it tight. You take them home to your wife or your husband. You know, you call mom and say, mama, this is what I got to do. I went to college for you because most black folks, if we're going to keep it real, went to college for mama. But I am going to do this for me because I'm about to build my legacy. We built 3/4 of this world. And if we built 3/4 of this world, then we are probably the most powerful force in the universe. So what we need to do is put our feelings in check and understand that your feelings have nothing to do with it. You don't know what's going on behind the counter at McDonald's when you order your Big Mac. You don't care how the person feels. You don't care if you're in New Jersey and they still pump your gas because you can't pump your own. What they're feeling when they pump your gas, you want 25 on pump one. The end. That's what it comes down to. Separate how you feel about it to what the people actually are coming to you for. Whatever that product or service is. And in order to do that, remember, it is not about your product, nor is it about your service. People don't buy products or services. That's an illusion. They buy people and stories. So if you focus on building who you are up and telling your story of tragedy to triumph or overcoming or dealing with depression, self-esteem, whatever it is, you will be successful. I can teach you the technical stuff all day. We can do P&L sheets. That's no problem. We can talk about an email funnel. That's no problem. I can help you write a book. That's no problem. But if you're not right here, no matter what I say to you, it's not going to register. So we got to make sure we bury the feelings, focus on the job ahead. Remember who you are, people and stories, not products and services.
You said people and stories. Now, someone right below, they wrote, Dave, and Charles Carey says, get it, Dave. You're making it happen out there. Constance Carter says, absolutely. She's from Memphis, Tennessee. She's on now. CC Carter shares hers. Tanya shares hers. Look. Tawana Dobie, she said something. Now, she had a challenge. Now, I asked folks, if they had a challenge, we may have one idea, one solution. Agree with you. Separate feelings from actions. I'm kind of paraphrasing what you said there. Yep. But separate feelings from actions. So you can feel like not doing something, but you can do it anyway. Like, you can feel like not doing it and do it anyway. Good point there. Her question, I posted up there, Dave. Her question was, my challenge is fully understanding how to leverage. Now, she didn't frame it for us, but I'm going to put how to leverage her skill set in the marketplace so she can partner with other folks. Now, you know, Dave, I know one of the challenges I see out there sometimes is that folks are so worried about working with other people. You know, Trevor and I had that same thing. We kind of started. It was like, you know what? Be careful right now, because if you bring on other folks that do the same thing or do something similar, then you're losing business. And I'm not saying that's what she said, but her question is, how does she leverage her talent and her treasures? And what I found, and I'm gonna let you answer it, Dave, is that sometimes people have the scarcity mindset where they're like, it's all about me, or be careful because I don't want you coming into my territory, versus stepping back and saying, you know what, there's plenty for everyone. There's an abundant mindset they could have. What's an idea that you have, Dave? And then I'll share one after you that Tanya can do. And Tanya, thank you for being open. Thank you for being authentic. Yeah. Thank you for participating. And thank you for asking the question. Dave, what are your thoughts on how she can leverage? Now, you can frame it however you want. I just took one piece of it.
No, I like the way you frame it, Tanya. I would say, first of all, you have a lot of skills that you're probably not using to their full advantage. So many of us are taught to compete. I do not believe in competition. I believe in complete domination, which is why when I see a situation, whether it's a speaking engagement, a book signing, a Nutrisystem or Red Bull, I come in there already with the mindset that, well, if they don't know me when I walk through the door, they will never forget me again. So many of us just want to just get in there, you know, put me in, coach. It's like I grew up in the hood, so kids would take wires and play double dutch, and there was always one girl kind of doing like this, trying to get herself in there, but she never actually took the leap. And my whole thing is, if you're great at what you do, stand in it. We're told to be humble. We're told to bring it down. My favorite book says, do not hide your light under a bushel. So at the end of the day, I am going to shine. I am not going to play any games whatsoever, and I'm going to do whatever it takes to get to the next level. Act from a domination mindset, and you won't have to worry about leverage, because everyone will try to figure out how they can leverage their skills and talents to work with you. Reverse it.
Reverse it. I like that. Reverse it. Look, you know, Dave shared it, and Dave, I'm going to come right back to you. Tawana said, that sounds like me. I'm working. I'm no longer going to sit back. Thanks a lot. And if you see her out there, just let her know what CeCe Carwell says. I'm going to focus now on competing with myself. Toya says, come on, the Bible. All right now. Someone said, talent to treasure. How true is that? How true is that? You know, one of the things that, you can do if you want to leverage your skill set, and it's something that is two words. It's just two words. I'm going to try to make it as easy as I can in the time we have. It's called the giver's economy. That's what Trevor and I always say. The giver's economy. Matter of fact, hashtag giver's economy. How can you give? So you have your talents, you have your treasure, you have your skills. And I love what you said there, Dave. What I'll be thinking about is, how can I give to someone else? How can I help someone else? How can I come from a place of service? We're going to get into sales, David. I know selling equals service. Selling equals service. David's my sales buddy over there. I've been reading all about him. I didn't know that. I just found out about the guy today. So we're going to get into that sales conversation, make you some money. Yeah. It's going to be a money conversation. You want to hang in there, because I don't know how long we're going to end. The internet could go down for all I know. So you want to pay close attention. Let me slow down so I can speed up. The giver's economy. So when you want to leverage and you want to partner, ask yourself, what am I bringing to the table that can help serve someone else? George C. Frazier, one of our mentors, used to tell us all the time, Dave. He said, look, even in a good book, everyone is invited to the table the first time. Whether they have something or not, they're invited to the table the first time to participate. Then whether you get invited back a second or third or fourth time starts depending on what you can bring to the table. So when you leave, you got to go do something with what you have. Look, share your gift, share your gift. If you're out there right now, you hear me, and you believe that you can give, 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 and you will receive. Look right below. Just type two words, hashtag giver's economy. We're going to have a free gift. I don't know what Dave's going to give away. We're going to give something away. I don't know what it is, Dave. We're going to figure something out in a minute. But you look right below and just put hashtag giver's economy. Come on, be a part of this network. Be a part of the Black CEO, which is really a contribution network to be able to give. Dave is giving. I just stroked Dave a check. I didn't pay him. He didn't ask me for a credit card. He came in here to give the best that he has. And that's what he does. That's why he's here. Look, Dave, for the person out there right now and thinking, you know what? Okay, I need something technical, but I'm having this mindset challenge, right? I'm having this mindset. Like, I know what to do, Dave, but I ain't doing it, right? I know what I should be doing, but I'm not doing it. I was doing that the other day, Dave. I went to the allergies. I have allergies, by the way. I'm a runner, and I have to get a shot once a week, and I'm supposed to take this medicine. Well, last week, I had dizzy spells. I had to lay down. The room was spinning, and I thought I had a problem until I saw my doctor, and I called him. He said, Shay, are you taking your medicine? Well, I'm not saying medicine. For those that are listening, it's allergy medicine. Don't say I'm on allergy medicine. I said, well, I've been feeling okay, doc, the last 6 months. The answer is no. So I had a problem, Dave. I went to the doctor. He gave me a prescription, two prescriptions. I go once a week, and guess what I did? I didn't take the medicine because it was during the wintertime. I said, I'm fine. And bam, as soon as it hit me, guess what? I had a head cold. I had to lay down. So sometimes we know what to do, but if it's jot this in your notes, it's easy to do and it's easy not to do. It's easy to do and it's easy not to do. I'm going to ask Dave right now, what does he say to the Black CEO? He and I having a conversation. Dave, I need help too. Okay, I'm being vulnerable. I'm taking my medicine now. See, my nose isn't running. Life's okay. Yeah. Dave, what's the idea you share for the person out there that says, I need to have the right mindset? It's time for me to step it up. Nolita says she's part of the giver's economy, by the way. Brian Boone said he's part of the giver's economy, by the way. Janara Shannon says she's part of the giver's economy, by the way. Toya says this technology is impeccable. Nikia Nicole, hey, Nikia, thanks for joining. She says, I'm part of the hashtag giver's economy. Kelly Thomas says, I'm part of the giver's economy. So it's constant. So it's Fred Williams. He said, that's dope. Giver's economy. Jocelyn Newsom said, I'm part of the giver's economy. Look, you guys know who you have on the other side. I'm going to introduce her in a minute. Tawana Jackson said she's part of the giver's economy. And so did Claras. So did Laverne. She says she's part of it. So many people are part of the giver's economy. Now that they know what to do, Dave, give them the right mindset. And how do they do what they know they should do? Don't be like Shay Brown, okay? follow the instructions. Dave's going to give you the prescription right now. You're coming to the business bully, the expert himself. And he's giving it to you, and it costs nothing. But you got to do it. Over to you, Dave.
All right, so here's the thing. People don't realize how special they are. And, you know, you have to understand that because we've been conditioned to believe that we're just okay, that we're less than, that we're some kind of derivative, we're amazing. We're the people that everybody copies. So when you come from that perspective, you just have to say, I'm going to execute no matter what. And here's what I do. Simplest thing in the world. I have so much on my plate that I can sometimes miss things, you know, and I have an issue with trying to be consistent. This is me being as transparent as I've ever been. So I take six things from the time I wake up at 4 a.m. to the time I go to bed, and I knock out those six things, and that's it. That way I can kind of get myself into a rhythm. So I know on Monday, these are the six things I need to do. Tuesday, you know, so on and so forth, you know, and I technically usually take one day off just so that I can spend with my family. But even then, there's always one thing, an interview I have to do, a podcast, a consult, a sales call that just can't wait. But even with that, it's not about balance. It's about making sure that you compromise, because it'll never be even. If you're always in the middle, you're going to be average. One thing has to be up, and then the other thing has to be down. When I'm on vacation, you can't reach me. I put a team in place. We're not alone. So we have to start doing things that are actionable and find people who don't complete what we have, but complement what we offer. And then we exchange what we have so that they can take it, and they give us what they have so we can take it, and everybody benefits. It is about the collective, not the individual. The individual will benefit if the collective works together.
Now, do you use software for that, Dave, or do you write it down? I mean,
I got real fancy software. It's called a book. I sit down and I take the book and I write down, okay, I'm going to do this. It's called a planner. My wife was like, Dave, forget all this technology, your apps, your hang whiffs, and your speakers. Take your behind to the store and get a planner. And that's what it is. Pen to paper. You know what I mean? If it was good enough for Moses, it's good enough for me.
Man, I love that. I love that. Now, we're talking to none other than the David Anderson. He's the business editor of allhiphop.com. 2 million plus views and thousands of subscribers on his YouTube. He's the first director of social media of both Radio One, hear me, and iHeartMedia. He started in radio at 9 and he retired. Hear me out. Retired at 34. I've got a question for you, Dave. Why are you committed to the Black CEO community? I mean, certainly you could be doing a whole lot with your time, with your talent, and with your treasure, but why are you committed to the Black CEO community?
The reason I'm committed is because I want to see our people win, and I want to be around people who are serious. There's some of us who are not serious, who are not willing to dedicate themselves, who are not willing to invest financially, emotionally, spiritually, and of their gifts and talents in order to make everyone better. But then they're always like this. Gimme, 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 gimme. And then the other thing is, you have people who are acting like a waiter at their own dinner table, to quote The Color Purple. In other words, they're doing this Oliver Twist thing. Please, sir, might I have more? Please, here's my business plan. Might you give me a loan? Please, sir, can I just be great on your platform instead of developing my own? Like, we got to stop that. And the only way for me to do that is to go where the people are who are serious about that and who are about that life when it comes to sales and marketing and promotion and spirituality and distribution and exercise and wellness. And all of those things happen in the Black CEO community. So why would I not? I've been here from the beginning. You might not have noticed me because I'm humping in the key of one, grinding, writing books, snapping necks and cashing checks, but I'm here. And I will always be here for people who look like me, who are serious about their time, money, energy, and talents.
Yeah, but you're saying that, Dave, but there's some folks that are listening right now, and they may be curious, did you get here alone? I know I had a first conversation with you, and you shared a story about your grandfather and so forth, and there's so many folks on here right now that believe that because they're a Black CEO, they've done it and they made it and they made it by themselves. And maybe that's true. I don't know if you're a first generation or second generation, but if you could step back and kind of share the story. I know you talked the story in detail about the grandfather and the pace that it went on. Do you mind kind of sharing it with the audience so we can frame the conversation? I want you out there right now, as you're listening, listen very, very carefully with new ears.
Okay.
Watch right now with new eyes as Dave kind of talks about his journey, how he got here and his story. Over to you, Dave.
All right. So real quick, before I get to my mother's father, my father's father was born a slave. My father's father was born in 1864. He had my father very, very late in life in 1935. Mm. So I'm only two generations removed from slavery on my father's side. On my mother's side, my grandfather dropped out of school. His family ran a peanut farm, and they were struggling because at that point they had land in Virginia that other people wanted. And my grandfather was a lot like me. He had a big mouth, and sometimes he just didn't like to let injustice slide. So they were going to lynch him. Upon hearing this, my father hitches a ride on a train to the docks and lies and enlisted in the Navy. And then he served, I think, two tours, came back, and migrated to Philadelphia because he never could go back to Virginia again until his children became adults. And he wound up meeting a woman in a class. He was going to school, and he became a tailor by trade. He meets that woman, and 8 months later, they're married. 9 months after that, my mother was born. You know, and my grandfather, although he never got a formal education, made sure all of his children, with the exception of one, got college educations, master's levels, or better. You know, and this is a man who had a PhD in wit and common sense, and taught me how to lay cement and concrete when I was 7 years old. Who told me the importance of taking care of people and doing right by people, and trying to make sure that as long as you wear the skin, you have a responsibility. You know, and he was humble enough to shine shoes to make sure his children ate. You know, he ate out of garbage cans and made sure that his kids had. You know, that's the stock I come from. So I'll be damned if I just sit back and just coast, you know, off of that man's sacrifices, you know, off of any of my family's sacrifices. I'm bigger than that, you know, and that's why I'm here, man. And that's why I do what I do. You can have your own reasons. Those are mine.
Man, that's so powerful. Look, if you're out there right now and you're listening to Dave and you heard with Dave's story and you're like, you know what? I believe, Shay, that this is my year coming up. Or I believe, Shay, that this is my month. Or I believe this is my week. Or maybe, Dave, they're out there and you believe this is your moment, that this is your time. Just look right below. Just look right below and type the words #. I believe. That's you. That's you. I mean, Dave believes. Dave, you believe. Is that correct?
I do believe.
Dave believes that it's possible. Dave, why do you believe and it's possible that someone's listening right now, no matter where they start from, no matter what's going on in their life? Some of them right now, Dave, they're doing very, very well. Life is good, but it can get to another level. Others have had some high highs and some low lows. I've been there. And others they're back on the ground. I've been there too and have to look up. Why, Dave, do you believe in the entrepreneur that's out there, the black CEO who's falling right now or maybe going through some tough, tough times, and they're typing the words, I believe. And as you see someone right now, and right below the video, you type the words, #, I believe the best is yet to come. Just put #, I believe. Just hit the like button. Just encourage them because they may have to encourage someone else. Dave, why do you believe in the black CEO today?
I'll tell you this, and I believe, you know, because, you know, my greatest inspiration is Jesus Christ, and Jesus spoke in stories and parables, and so I do. I went to a meeting once, and there was a young woman there, and she was stressed and distraught. She had this company, and she did not know what to do with it. She was all over the place. She couldn't focus, and I zone out. You know, when I talk business, it's my thing. You know, last name is Anderson. It's like I'm in the Matrix. I can see things that people can't see in the code. And I'm telling her, hey, did you do this? Did you do that? Did you do this? And by the time I came out of my Matrix code thing, I'm looking and tears are just streaming down her face. Because what I had to say was very hard and it was harsh and there were hard conversations. And we found some tissues and we gave them to her. And I said, listen, I just want to help you. I'm not saying this to hurt you. I want to support you because you got kids. You got, you know, you have a partner. You have things going on where you need somebody to help you. And now she's making 5 figures a month, you know. But, You have to believe. You have to hold on to something else. When I lost everything, 2,200 square foot apartment in Arlington, Texas, where the Rangers and the Cowboys play. When I lost, you know, two out of three cars, only kept the truck. When I had lost everything, my reputation, my dignity, the whole nine. When I was washing up in the gas station sink, I held on to the belief that this is only temporary. I'm Dave Anderson. This is not how my life is supposed to be. This ain't how it's going to end. I'm going to get up. I'm going to figure out a way to make it happen. And I saved up enough money and I bought myself back and I lived in my brother's garage and I did what I had to do. And then all of a sudden I wrote an article called The Top 10 Reasons the BET Awards Made Me Want to Vomit. I went to sleep, you know, because I posted the article on Facebook. I went to sleep and I woke up and people are hitting me like, yo, you know, you're in the LA Times. I'm like, me? And they're like, yeah, you know, BT made you want to vomit, right? I'm like, so I get the LA Times and it's right there. I had a moment. It was that moment. Sometimes it's timing. My wife says to me all the time, David, everything happens in divine order. I met my wife when I was 17 years old and walked up to her and said, I'm Dave Anderson and I'm going to marry you. She said, you're crazy. I said, what does that have to do with what I told you? You know, you fast forward a good 12, 15 years later. Yeah. Finally, we got married. You know, timing is everything. So don't worry so much about the process. Don't worry so much about when it's going to happen. You know it's going to happen. And you have to hang on to that belief because sometimes that belief is all you have. That belief is the one thing keeping you alive. And I know what it is to stand on the roof and look down and say, you know what, I could drop and won't nobody miss me. I know what it is to stand in the kitchen and say, I can take a razor blade and won't nobody miss me. You will be missed because you're here for a distinct purpose that you need to fulfill. So you have to believe. Your belief is all you have sometimes, and it's enough. It is a foundation that you can build the rest of your life.
And folks, right below, they're typing the words. Queen says, thank you so much, sir. She believes, Dave. Linda Blake says, I believe because of your story there. Tammy Turner says, I believe because of your story there. Ashton Jordan says, hashtag, I believe. LaShonda McCarty says, I believe. Miss Fema says, I believe. Alexander says, I believe. There's so many folks below that are saying, I believe. Anisha Linton Garrett says, thanks for sharing your truth, Dave. They believe that you've been there. And sometimes when they watch or they see this day, they think that life's just been perfect. That life's been perfect for them. What is it? Life ain't no crystal stair. And they don't understand that we've been to the bottom of the bottom of the bottom. I mean, I've been in places where I sat back and said, how did I find myself here? No one would ever hear me. No one ever listened to me ever again in my life. And just like you, Dave, you think maybe it's over. And folks told me, Dave, they may have told you that as well. Jay, hang it up. No, I don't know. Hang it up. And, you know, I said to myself, it's possible. If I just believe, yep. I find someone with a problem that we can serve and come from a place of service. Dave, you decided to be a Black CEO. We're having one Black CEO conversation to another. And, you know, what is something that someone can do out there? And they might be thinking, look, Dave, if I can just get in front of the right people, we're going to prospecting for those folks that want to know where I'm going. And they like, I just can't find any qualified people out there, Dave. I'm a financial planner or I'm a business coach. Or I sell light bulbs, or I sell office supplies. I help nonprofits, Dave, and I can't find anyone out there that wants to work with me. I'm struggling to find someone. And some folks call that their lead generation system, Dave. Some folks, as you're listening, might be saying, what is Shay talking about? I'm a Black CEO. Okay, your prospecting system. Some of you might be wondering, how do I go find new customers? We get it, okay? We get it. Let me frame it, okay? For so long, when I got started, Dave, I was told, you know, call a list over and over again until they say yes, right? No one really, I didn't have all of these different techniques. Just get as many no's as you can, and sooner or longer, you'll get a yes. So I became what's called a hunter. That means I go out every day, and I find someone, and I don't want to say kill, but I eat off what I kill, right? That's just a mindset. Right. I didn't know any better. Others are what they call a farmer. They sit back, and they try to figure out, okay, this is the little land I have, and let me nurture it and bring it up. So whether you're a hunter or a farmer, you like to go out there and find new people, or you want to mine what you have, I want Dave to kind of help, because he's the business bully here, and maybe share an idea or a technique that can help you, as you're listening, go out there and find some new clients. Maybe a system, maybe a something that you can do right away. I'll give an idea. Dave's going to give an idea. So, David, I'm going to turn it over to you. They all type the word hashtag I believe. And I see someone, Lakeisha says, I'm a hybrid of both of those. Well, of course, one's your primary and one's your secondary. But yes, Dave, over to you, my man. What do you say to that black CEO? And say it to Shay Brown, too. I want to listen as well.
Stop trying to be cool.
I like
that. Let me put that another way. See, what's happened is people have got this cool thing messed up. They have it in their heads that being cool sometimes sets you apart, and it doesn't. Being cool is another way to wrap up conformity and better packaging. And so what happens is, whether we're business coaches or accountants or financial planners or lawyers, what we tend to do is do what everybody else does. And because you do what everybody else does, you become just another fish in a very, very large, vast ocean. And you're not hitting on nothing, you're not eating anything, and you're starving, you're wasting away. You have to find a way to stand out. For me, all I had to do was be who I am. I'm not the person who says the politically correct thing. I am not the person who will just say, oh, well, that's okay. No, defend your opinion. Convince me I'm wrong. You know, I will show you facts, and I will beat you down with facts. And that's the thing. People know I'm not here to coddle with them. I'm not Joel Osteen. I'm not T.D. Jakes. I'm not here to preach you some happy sonnet to make your day go better. My name is David, but I don't sing psalms. So my whole thing is find a way to get above the clutter. So let me give you some suggestions. Number one, the number one search engine on the planet is Google. The number two search engine on the planet is YouTube. If you go right now to Google and type in business bully, I'm what comes up. 9 out of 10 of the first page is this guy right here. That is because I stayed consistent in order to do so. And that's what I teach my students in the Business Bully Club. You know, we get together every Thursday and I beat them down. I mean, I'm very vicious, but I teach them how to use the technology available to them to help stand out. You can't do, if you're a jewelry maker and there's 15 other jewelry makers and you're all in a farmer's market, well then guess what? You know, you will have to have something spectacular, or you're going to have a spectacular presentation. You know, and that's why I wrote Pitch, Close, Upsell, Repeat, because it's about putting what you already have, which can be good or it can be hot dog crap. McDonald's has made a career off of mediocre burgers. So, largest landowner in the entire world, you know, grade D, almost canner quality meat, yet and still, to all beef patty, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions on a sesame seed bun is ingrained in your skull. If you can't read, you know that golden arch and that red bottom automatically means McDonald's. Why? Because they were consistent and they found a way to stand out, and they created a system that everybody copies. Burger King, Papa John's, Pizza Hut, Wendy's, Chipotle, all of them have modeled themselves after McDonald's. It's not about how good your product is. It's not about how good your product is. It's how good you serve it up. And I am an excellent server. Ain't but one server better than me. Her name is Serena Williams. I serve you this bully work. That's what you need to do.
You know, as you talked about serving them, Dave, which I like, we talked about the giver's economy. We talked about providing. We talked about giving. We don't really have a plan. We're just having a conversation. But I'm curious, is there something that you can give to the person that's watching right now? I mean, something that you could, you know, maybe do. I'm not putting you on the spot, but I'm putting you on the spot. You like to give of your time and talent and treasures. What is something that you can do for the person that's watching right now? The business owner, the black CEO watching right now. They're taking time, Dave. You know, you can always make more money, but you can't make more time. What is it that you would want to give away, you'd want to share? Go ahead and share that with me. I know you weren't prepared to, but I wanted to do that as well. And I also, Dave, as I'm thinking about it, the biggest challenge that you think about what you're going to give away is, you know what? Folks out there have got to shift And they've got to do something to get in front of people who have a problem. Because what you talked about earlier, folks saying, I can't find people to work with me. You know, I'm tired of hearing that person myself, because wherever I go, when I say what's the number one challenge, it isn't I'm closing. The number one challenge is I can't get in front of enough qualified people. So let me just share two things while Dave thinks about the type of gift he's going to give away. Let me share two things, because you've got to do something. And the reason I'm into this, Dave, as well, is that I know what it was like to be down and out. And the only way I was going to build myself back, the only way I was going to build myself back was to be able to generate revenue in the business. So let me share two things that you can do, because you've got to be able to do this. Go ahead and jot this down. You know, this is going to help you like right now. You've got Dave on here who's written sales books. I just want to share one area. One's going to be simple, and then some's going to be a little more complex, okay? But let me give you something simple that you can do, and it's a game changer, okay? It's a game changer. So wherever you find yourself in a position before, and you kept saying to yourself, you know what? I'm not in front of people. I don't have enough business. Now, Black CEO was created as a content distribution network, but also to help you have business-based wealth. Jot that down. You know, someone put that right below. Business-based wealth. Now, there's a whole lot of ways to get wealth. You can get wealth going out there if you want in real estate, and that's fine. That works. You can go out there and get it if you want from a financial planning perspective, and that works. But I want you to step back right now, and if you're a Black CEO, and think to yourself, okay, business-based wealth, I've got to go serve someone. I've got to go find people with a problem and then solve it. And I've got a problem right now. I don't have enough qualified prospects. I don't have enough leads in my hand, right? So here's one thing you're going to do to create business-based wealth. In fact, look right below, put the name of your business. I'm going to let you spotlight your business. Look, Dave, we're going to let them spotlight your business right now, because I'm here to make a difference and help you find your sales courage, like right now. We'll help you find this sales courage, so that won't be you anymore that's out there. So number one, look right below, and put business-based wealth. Just go ahead and put that right below, and then put the name of your business. Just jot that, put the name of your business right now. Here's one thing you can do. Jot this down. First thing I want you to do is I want you to have scheduled block time. Now, you're not going to be like out there thinking this is going together. You're not going to think this is a big game changer. But think about it. If you're struggling with finding folks who have a problem, you're struggling with your lead generation system, then why not have scheduled block time where that's all that you focus on? Don't be on LinkedIn. Don't be on Facebook. Don't be tweeting. But at least have scheduled block time, at least 2 hours a day that you're going to dedicate. Now, you might be thinking, okay, Shay, but where do I find the leads? Because you've heard for so long that the money is in the list. The money is in what? The list. And you're thinking, I don't have a list. But let me give you the Shay Brown remixed version. That's right. I'm a product of the 80s. Okay. The remixed version. Pup Daddy's part of my generation. Okay. Part of my generation. And here it is. The money is in other people's lists. So how do you go from just having your list and having scheduled block time to partner to leverage with someone else, not to get into their list, but to give value to their list? See, it's all about value. See, you can find your sales courage. It's like right below. Dave's going to give a gift away. I don't know what he's going to do. But you're going to find your sales courage. I'm going to give you a second one. But first, schedule block time and then partner with other people so you can get value and get in their list. So right below, type two words. I don't know what I'm going to give away. I'm going to give something away too. I don't know what it is. Dave, we're going to give. But you look right below and you put #SalesCourage. #SalesCourage. Because once you have the sales courage, then you will then be able to get in front of people who have a problem. But we're not going to stop there, because we're going to step back for those that put #SalesCourage. And we're going to teach you your signature selling style. Now, it's possible. You might have been a Black CEO for many, many years. Some of you, this is your first time. You're like, oh, I just saw this going on, thought I'd show up, seemed pretty cool. But truthfully, as you're listening to me, like, Shay, I don't know my sales courage. I mean, I don't know my signature selling style. What is my primary signature selling style? So that I can be authentic, so that I can be myself. And then once I take that type of assessment, it's going to cost you nothing, by the way, but you got to put #SalesCourage. You got to look below. I'm only going to track sales courage. #SalesCourage. Once you understand your signature selling style, and this is a little bit advanced, it's a little fur, but y'all have been with us for just a little bit, and some of you have never heard of your signature selling style, but once you understand your style, there's about 10 different ones, then you can go over and you can drive the marketing plan. See, You determine a conversation. You drive the conversation. The conversation doesn't really define you. So you're going to define your signature style. Then you're going to talk to the marketing folks and say, hey, look, this is who I'm trying to attract to my style, to my message, to my voice, to my personality. And once you do that, then you can put a system in place. Ask yourself the question, have I put a system in place to help me understand my signature selling style so I can be in front of the right people at the right time with the right message, with the right product? Let me tell you about one of our clients recently we were working with, and this was just last month. She was really struggling. Not struggling because she didn't have all the systems, all the bells, all the whistles. She has all the gadgets, by the way, just to let you know that, Dave. She has all the gadgets. Who doesn't have those gadgets, right? Right? She found herself in a situation, and I asked her, I said, do you know your signature selling style? She's like, Shay, you know how much money I've spent, but no. What is it? Is this something you created? I said, no. We've been doing this all the time, full time, for 15 years. We study the best of the best, and we study the worst of the worst. And we've been on both sides many, many times. And we determined that there's personality traits that they have. And so no one did that for me when I got into the industry. They just didn't. So we created this assessment. She was able to step back. We were able to create the assessment and then create the marketing that attract people to her style. Really pleased. Last month, she did a little over $20,000-some. Is that everyone's answer? And this is over and beyond what she would have earned if she didn't have it. Now, myself and Dave, we're that type of folks who I take credit for everything that our clients do. That's not what we do. But oftentimes we're catalysts. We get the motion and going. And some of you out there right now, you only want business when it's convenient. You only want business when someone just comes to you. You only want business when someone picks up the phone, they call and say, someone asked me to give you a call because they said you could do this. But no. Okay, jot this down in your notes. Put this in your notes. Now, I know some of you put sales courage. I'm going to give a giveaway. Dave's coming to you. I got on a rant. I'm going to come to you. Dave's going to give a giveaway. He said, Shay, I was coming. Okay, but put this in your notes. Okay, I want you to have this because this does not have to be you. It was me and many of my clients. Here it is. The list of people who don't know you right now is so much longer than the list of people who do know you. I want you to hear. I want you to look. You need your sales courage. The list of people who don't even know you on the planet, they don't even know you exist right now, is so much longer than the list of people who do know you. And why is that? Why am I spending a little bit of time on leads? Why did I get so passionate? Dave lit this fire in me. Why? Jot this in your notes. Leads represent hope. Leads represent hope. Let me say it again. Leads represent hope. No leads, no what? Hope. That's right. No leads, no hope. If you believe that, just look right below and put leads represent hope. Hashtag sales courage. Again, hashtag sales courage. Leads represent hope. Dave's here to give you hope. When you have leads, you have hope. You want to earn an extra $10,000, an extra $20,000. And what would you even do with the money? Let's say you had an extra $5,000 a month or $10,000 a month. Over and beyond whatever it is you're earning today, what would you do with the extra money? Now, maybe some of you $10,000 to get you excited. Maybe you can earn $20,000 more because you have a team. Maybe it's pay off your house. Maybe it's retired. Dave said he retired at 34. Maybe it's send your kids to a school of your choice. Dave and I were talking. Talk about Howard University. I'm a Morgan State guy. He went to Temple, by the way. Maybe you want to send your kids to a school of their choice. I don't know what it is for you, but here's what I do know. The cash flow solves a lot of problems. It's not everything, but it solves so many problems. So you can find your sales courage. You can learn your signature selling style, and you can have that at no cost to you. And if that's you, you're out there listening before Dave gives his gift away. If that's you, and you listen and say, Shay, that's me. That's me. You're talking to me. Dad, you're talking to me. Look, here's my gift, Dave. In about 1 minute, I'm coming over to you. Here's what you need to do. Text the word Black CEO Makeover. That's a gift. You're going to get the signature selling style. So you take the assessment. No cost to you. There's no cost to you. Just type in, text the word Black CEO Makeover. Get the assessment. No cost to you. At least learn your signature selling style and have a conversation about your business. No cost to you. And that's our gift that we're going to give you because, look, you got to stop winging it. You've got to stop shooting from the hip, shooting from the lip, trying to be continuously, spontaneously brilliant. If this is your moment, which I believe it is, if this is your time, which I believe it is, then you've got to raise your standard and you've got to step up. I believe in you. Dave believes in you. Even if you don't believe right now, even if you don't believe, then just say Shay Brown holds the belief for you. Dave holds the belief for you. The Black CEO community holds the belief for you. So here's what I'm going to do. Text the word Black CEO to this number, 202-270-1662. Someone put that in the feed for me right below, just real quick. But the number is 202 202-270-1662. Let me give it to you. 202-270-1662. Text the word Black CEO Makeover, Black CEO Makeover, and have a conversation. Get the free assessment. That's my gift. That's for you, so you can generate prospects. Most of you, if you get in front of more qualified people and you share how you solve a problem, the magic will happen by itself. The law of averages will be in your favor, and you do that. And I'll tell you, this will be your best year ever. Okay, Dave, back over here, man. I got a little lost there. I got on there, but I wanted to help some folks out. I mean, I'm feeling right now there's someone out there, they don't need to change their life, but they believe they have the potential inside of them to perform at a much higher level. And do you know what all successful people believe? All Black CEOs believe. They hold one common belief. According to Shea Brown, no one's validating me on this, but according to Shea Brown, here's what it is. They hold the belief they can always get better. They can always get better. There's another level to raise that standard. Myself, Dave included, always working on our game. So with that being said, text the word Black CEO Makeover. Black CEO Makeover. I'll give you a number, 202-270-1662. Look, find your sales courage, and this will be your best year. Okay, Dave, again, got on it a little bit there. Back over to you, my man. I want you to do something special. Tell the folks why you're willing to do something special, because, you know, you didn't know you were, but you are now because you're here. It's the giver's economy, baby. Over to you.
Well, all right. Well, you know, since you put me on the spot, I don't back down from a challenge. Otherwise, I wouldn't be much of a bully, now would I? First and foremost, the one thing that I will tell you is that I am not cheap, okay? Cheap is McDonald's. I'm not a cheap person because I bring a certain level of value to what it is that I do. And there are people who would say, well, you know, I don't have, you know, a few $100 to just pop down for an hour of your time. I don't have, you know, that kind of, you know, capital available. I put everything I got into my business. My kids got to go to camp. Mom need a new pair of shoes. Daddy needs some dentures. I get it. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to find one person who can text business bully to 31996. Text business bully to 31996. When you do, there's two separate words, business bully, 31996.
You want 31196? I didn't hear it. Just say it one more time.
31996. 31996.
Okay, go ahead.
Text business bully to 31996. I'm going to select one person, and that one person will get a full scholarship to the Business Bully Club, which is my program. It's an intimate program with entrepreneurs where we do video conferencing, and I teach for about an hour, and then I do Q&A. And I'm also going to give you 1 hour to ask me anything about your business. No holds barred. That's a $5,000 value to sit down, and we go through your business with a fine-tooth comb, anything you want. 1 hour with me, plus a lifetime membership into the Business Bully Club. Now, if you don't win, that's cool too. I still want you to come and party, because I want to give you a code right now where you can actually get half off my normal tuition for the Business Bully Club. You go to bit.ly/2 join the bully. In other words, the number 2, capital J-O-I-N, capital T-H-E, capital B-U-L-L-Y. Why? Because you're awesome and you're Black CEOs and you're stepping up, and I want to be able to help you meet that challenge. So I'm giving you half off the tuition for those of you who don't win. So again, text business bully to 31996. I'm going to pick somebody. I'm going to pick somebody right now. And I am looking. I'm waiting to see who that person is. Oh, somebody just texted. Let's find out who the winner is. Let's see here. Hold on 1 second. I'm going to find out who actually just texted in here, and we're going to get a winner right now, Shea Brown. You see, I believe in instant massive action, bro. You know what I'm saying? So if you haven't texted in, I'm going to give you another 30 seconds, and then I'm going to go. I'm going to find out who actually stepped up, you know. So business bully to 31996, you know, and let's see who is there. We're going to check this out. Oh, folks are just popping in, bro. They are popping in. So we're going to see what it is, what it is, what it is. The suspense is killing me. It's killing me, Shaq.
Well, you
I can't take it. Oh, gosh. Let's see here. All right. Whoever is from area code 202. The last four of their numbers is 8074. So if you are the person at 202 and the last four is 8074, congratulations, you've won. Everybody else, you know, head over to that link, bit.ly/2, join the bully, you know, so that you can get hooked up and really get some hard answers and hard solutions to your problems.
Wow, congratulations. And the person's name once again?
I don't know the person.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. The last four digits. Okay, Cam is the person's name, obviously, because he has to wait till he responds to them. We'll find out who the person is. So, Dave, thanks a lot, one, for sharing that gift, my man. Why'd you come up with the business bully name? Where'd that even come from, by the way?
All right, well, here's what happened, right? I don't know where I was. I think I might have been in a Facebook group, and somebody didn't like something I said. And they said, oh, that Dave Anderson, he's so mean. He's not professional. I don't get it. He's just so mean. He's a business bully. I said, trademark. And that was that. I don't have a problem being the bad guy if I know that I'm doing what I need to do. Somebody's got to be the bad guy. You know, somebody's got to be the one to say, you know what? You don't deserve a trophy for being in third place. You don't deserve to have greatness if you're not actually being great. You don't deserve to have millions of people follow you if you are not worth following. If you don't know where you're going, why should you be rewarded for that? Why are we so happy to accept mediocrity? No. So that was my thing. I was like, no, if you want me to be the business bully, I'll be that. And I'll be the best damn business bully I know how to be. And so here we are.
And what does that mean to the person that's listening right now? And it's, they think of business bully. What do you want them to think of?
I want them to think of accountability. Mm-hmm. I want them to think about what it means to wake up every day with a purpose, a burning desire to be free. I mean, truly free, because many of us are not truly free. We have to go and call somebody boss. Mm-hmm. We have to, you know, do certain things. We're worried about having more month at the end of the money, you know. And so I want to push you, because there's a mogul inside of you. Yes, even you, right? You. Well, I'm not a big personality. I just can't get on here, and I couldn't talk to Shay Brown for an hour. And just you too, because you are robbing your children. You are robbing your future self. The AARP Social Security version of you that is going to thank me for kicking your young, ignorant behind is going to be so happy that you're sitting in Costa Rica somewhere, sitting back chilling, because you got the push that you needed. Sometimes you don't need someone to tell you, you're great. You got mommy for that. You need somebody that's going to scare you into action, and that's what I do. I bully you into action. I had to bully myself. I remember sitting in a Quick Trip on 360 and Carrier in Arlington, Texas, washing up in a gas station sink, and I'm like, I don't even want to go on. And like, you've ever seen those movies where like the version of you in the mirror is talking to you? It's like, what the hell is wrong with you? Get out. This isn't what you do. And that's what it is. So if I'm willing to bully myself, then I'm willing to bully you into your greatness, because you deserve the best version of you. Your audience, your customers, your clients, the people that you promised yourself that you would serve deserve the best from you. The people who sacrificed for you to be here deserve the best from you. All those people you beat, all those sperm you beat getting to that egg to fertilize it to make you you, deserve the best that you have to give, because you won that race. You can win any damn. Tracy Stubblefield. So Tracy Stubblefield is going to get one-on-one with me, and she's going to get a lifetime membership into the Business Bully Club. So I'm excited to help her with her business.
All right, Tracy. Let's give her hands. Give her a hand, Tracy. Way to go. Way to go. Way to go. Way to go. Now, David, as we're coming down the home stretch, I'm thinking, I like, you know, on the site, for those who haven't visited businessbullyshow.com. There's an article that you wrote on there called Black Sheep and Wrong Horses. Now, I'm going to give the quote here, Dave, and just frame the conversation, because for the persons out there that says, I'm nervous about being different. And I know when we started Black CEO with something, an idea that Trevor spoke up at an event, and he said that he's unapologetic about the culture distinction that he represents in the marketplace. And it was okay to be different. And there's number one producer of African-American experts and producers of African-American experts. And we were at a place where no one looked like us that was there. But yet afterwards, there was a conversation taking place with a line down the hall, Dave. They was wondering, well, who are these folks? How can I get access to them? Others out there saying, well, I can't be different. I mean, I got to be careful. Now, this is a quote. It comes from David Anderson. I'm going to ask him to kind of elaborate on what the theme of this black sheep and wrong horse is all about. He said, if being different makes you the black sheep of the family, that's okay. Black wool makes awesome sweaters. Talk about that for a moment, Dave, if you will.
Yeah, okay. So the thing of it is, I was always the different kid. Kids who wanted to sit around and roughhouse, there, like in the hood, they had this game because we didn't have much. We may have been able to get a tennis ball. And so they played this game called wall ball. And the person who was it had the honor and dubious distinction of throwing the ball up against the wall. And if the ball bounced, then that person was still it. But if somebody caught the ball, then that person became it and they threw it up against the wall. I thought this was an egregious waste of my time. Tree and I read a book. And they used to make fun of me for it. And they used to say I was weird and I was off. Oh, Dave just does, you know, weird things. And he marches to his own drummer. He's like, kid's a space case. He's weird. He's a nerd. He's a dork. Yeah. But I'd come back to Philadelphia. I think I was running a CBS radio in Austin at the time. And what wound up happening was there was this kid who used to bully me intently, like, you know, beat me up real bad the whole nine. And I'll never forget him. I won't mention his name. But I had gotten off the plane, I rented my car, and I decided, I was hungry. So I went to McDonald's, ironically, and I get to the take my order, said, no, I'm good. So sure enough, it's this kid, some 20 years later, who bullied me. And he said, man, I always thought you was going to be something. I knew you was going to be somebody. I said, yeah, then why did you beat me up? Because you was, you know, and I looked at that, and that's not putting that man down because he was in McDonald's. And I wasn't, but sometimes being different is the thing that makes you special. You were put here for a specific purpose. If your family don't get why you're here, look at the Munster. Remember the Munster, the TV show?
Yeah.
You had a Frankenstein, you had a bride of Frankenstein, you had a grandfather who's a vampire, you had a grandson who's a vampire. You know, you had all these folks who were weird, and then you had this beautiful girl, you know, who thought she was ugly because she didn't fit in with the rest of them. But as soon as she stepped outside, everybody on the block was trying to get with her. Some of us have Marilyn Munster syndrome because of who we're around. And sometimes once you get around new people, you have new thoughts and you take new actions. And so go ahead and be that black sheep. Just remember, your wool makes awesome sweaters. So that's what I mean by that. You need to stand in your truth and be proud of the God-given gifts you were blessed with.
Nah, that's, you know, Dave, that makes a whole lot of sense. If we can, I would like to take a step back and allow two things happen. Number one, I want you to come back on, man. We gotta have these black CEO conversations from one black CEO to another and just have a conversation around business, around success, around personal and professional development. You gave away a very, very special gift. I hope everyone texts in to make sure they got the gift. And then in a moment or two, I'm going to ask David, one, to talk a little bit about sales. And then we're going to have him. First, I'm going to get a commitment to see if he'll come back. I'm going to do that. Don't worry. I'm going to do that now. And then... And then we'll have a conversation about sales, and then we have some closing comments for those folks that are out there. But David, will you come back? Like, can we have this type of conversation again so folks can eavesdrop in on a conversation?
Man, you know, I love talking business. I can talk business. I love to.
Absolutely, absolutely. So if you can, share why sales is important. And then when you finish that, I'll make a comment. And then we're going to go ahead and bring it down to home stretch. We have a few closing comments for those folks that are out there listening right now. And over to you, my man.
All right. So sales is important because sales is the lifeblood of any business. Without sales, you got a hobby, you know. And with sales, you have a thriving business. Sam Walton started a corner store that is now Walmart. And whether or not Walmart employs more people on food stamps in America is irrelevant. The point of it is he had an idea and he ran with it. And he knew how to sell that idea. The McDonald brothers could, you know, were happy with their systems and so on and so forth. But it wasn't until Ray Kroc brought the franchising rights that McDonald's became the fast food giant that you now know it to be. You can't sit around and think that a kid whose father was a drug dealer who was killed at 3 years old, who wound up sleeping in the subway, would ever become a billionaire named Sean Combs. You can't tell me that sales isn't important. You need to know how to sell your product. You need to know how to sell your services. But most importantly, you need to know how to sell yourself. Because when you know who you are, there's nothing you can't sell, because you know what works. And if you believe in what it is that you have, you ought to be using it, and you ought to be doing everything in your power to make it happen. You need to wear it. You need to be your own brand. I mean, there's a reason I'm wearing a Business Bully Podcast shirt on. You want to know why? Because you might check out the Business Bully Podcast and might subscribe to it on iTunes or Stitcher or wherever you listen to shows. There is a reason. I live this every single day. This is not an act. I am like this every single day. I have to have that intensity. And depressed, and I don't know what to do, and I'm overwhelmed. And that's when I take a step back. I find out what's going on. I speak to my team. I talk to my wife. I talk to my kids. I take a break, and then I make things happen, and I get right back up, and I start hammering it out. I start beating it up. I start getting it in, because you know what? I am subject to a pimp named Bill, and Bill comes to my door every month. Sometimes he comes wanting his money for phones, his money for the lots, his money for the cable, but Bill want to be paid every month. And once I give it to him, he sends me a thank you card and says, "Thank you, son. Do it again." So as long as I'm beholden to Bill, I'm going to keep grinding. And that's what you need to do. You also need to be in a position, if you have children, to make sure that they don't have to have a job, that you can give them something to have a job, because that's what other races do. And I'm not saying be like other races, but I am saying that you have a responsibility to teach that ethic and to teach the responsibility of what it means to wear this skin to your children. And it's
okay, looks like we may have lost Dave there. I know I thought I saw the internet going on. I was texting to see if his internet was going in and out. We're gonna give him a moment to see if he can get back on. So I heard the internet kind of going squeaking in and out as he was sharing his story. Look, you know, for so long it's been said that sales is a bad word. When you think of a salesperson, you typically think of a liar. You think of someone that's a car salesman, someone that's sleazy, a person that's trying to get over on you. And that's not the reality. What I want you to know is that whether you're selling your product, you're selling your service, you're selling your idea, you are always, always selling. Teachers are selling educations, right? Pastors are selling religion, right? Parents every single day are selling values. We're always selling. We're always sharing our own unique perspective. And so why not embrace the one skill that can help fuel your purpose and your passion without sounding like a canned salesperson, without sounding like you're scripted. And that's why it's so important that you at least understand or know your signature selling style so that you can speak in an authentic voice. In fact, right below, type these words, no more sales scripts. No more sales scripts. Hashtag scripts are for actors, right? Scripts are for actors. And that's not you. That's not what you're looking to do. You're looking really to make a difference. You've got the right product. You have the right service. You have a big heart. And you want to do so much well. But in order to do that, you've got to be able to communicate with someone somewhere at some time. And even if it's automated, even if you don't like to sell, I would certainly suggest you do one thing. You hire someone who does. And for those folks that are out there that are listening right now and say, you know what, Jay? It sounds like me. I don't want to be salesy. If that's you, you can look right below and put no scripts are for actors. No more scripts. Hashtag no more scripts. If you're out there right now and you're thinking, you know what? How can I just be myself? How can I speak in my voice? I don't even want to memorize any words. Just put scripts. No more sales scripts. Hashtag scripts are for actors. Hashtag scripts are for actors, because they are. And if you're out there right now and you're like, you know what, Shay? Earlier you talked about an opportunity to maybe come in, spend 72 hours, have my branding looked at, have my marketing reviewed, look at the automation systems, make sure I have sequences in place that are running when I'm not there. Shay, it's time for me to reduce my labor. I need to automate my business. I want to reduce my labor. Then text the word Black CEO Makeover to the number 202-270-1662. Again, text the word Black CEO Makeover. Now, why would you do that? So you can have a conversation. You can walk away with one idea that you can use to reduce your labor. Why work hard? Sometimes folks are addicted to it. They go, I gotta work. But what if you could step back? What if you step from your business for 72 straight hours? You close the door. and you brought in a branding expert that was sharing what you could do in your business. You had a social media expert that was there at the table. You had a sales expert that was at the table. You had an automation guru that was there. What if you just had a conversation, said, what would it look like if I took what I'm doing now and automated the whole process? What would that look like? Look, maybe that's you. And you're like, you know, see, I never thought about that. It makes a lot of sense. I'm working way too hard. Oh, there he's back on. I'm working way too hard. And if that's you, text the word makeover to 202-270-1662. Again, Black CEO makeover to 202-270-1662. Let's just have that conversation. Let's just find out and say, okay, this is what you can do. Customize it specifically for you. All right, Dave, back over to you, man. You're looking clear there too.
Yeah, man. Had to reboot the system, bro. Why? Because I melted the daggone internet.
Well, you were wrapping up talking about why sales is important.
Right. So you can't put yourself in a position to win if you don't know how to sell. And if you don't know how to sell, if you're shy, you need to find somebody who can sell, or you need to get some training, or maybe you pick up pitch, close, upsell, repeat. This is sales domination. Pitch, close, upsell, repeat. This book, if you go, you can get it anywhere, Amazon, wherever you get books. This book will definitely change your life, you know, and it's one of those things where I wanted to put my process in how to sell for all types of people, whether you're shy, whether you're bold, whether you're cocky, whether you're brash, whether you're offensive, whether you don't know how to overcome objections. I wanted to be able to give you the tools in order to create a system that is going to allow you to make it happen. Pitch, close, upsell, repeat. It is the Bible when it comes to selling in this economy right now, in a giver's economy, in a Black CEO economy, in a 2017 economy. You need a 2017 game plan on how to sell. And that's what this is, you know, and I keep working to try and make that happen, you know, and I hope folks, you know, are willing to join me on this journey, because like I said before, man, if you get into that Bully Club today, you're going to get half off of your tuition. And that's at bit.ly/2jointhebully. All the words are capitalized, just the first letter of each. bit.ly/2. I'll put it up in my chat right now.
Okay.
Join the, you know, so that you can come and be with like-minded people, all different types of people. There are lawyers, there are doctors in private practice, there are clothing manufacturers, there are sales coaches, there are radio personalities, there are people who are putting on plays and stage shows, there are, you know, general contractors, there's all different types of businesses from all walks of life. This is for everyone. It's a general education, but I get really specific in the Q&As, and that's why people find it so valuable. You know, bit.ly/2jointhebully, because you need someone to help you get there. And I hope that something I said has sparked something in you. I hope that you feel like, you know, sales isn't a scary thing, because we've been conditioned that it's bad, and it's not. You know, so I want to be here to be able to be a resource, to be an aid for you. You know, when you see me out speaking, doing Black CEO events, I hope that you come by. You know, I hope that you, you know, grab a book, share a word, take a picture. I love selfies, because, I mean, who don't want to get a picture with me and this mohawk? I'm just saying.
You're so crazy. So Dave, what would be your closing comments? I love it. I put it up there. I love it. What would be your closing comments to the folks out there until we meet again, which we will very, very shortly. So pay attention, watch the broadcast, stay in the group. What would be your closing comments to the Black CEO that's out there right now? Your words of encouragement, your words of inspiration, or just thoughts that you have that are floating through your head right now. They want to be in the mind of Dave Anderson right now. What would you say to him?
Here's my thing. Don't think because there's somebody, don't fall for the sickness. A lot of us have fallen for the sickness that if it's Black, it's not as good, as if we're not the originators of almost any civilized thing on this planet. You need to realize that we are greatness. We are the originals. We're not the carbon copies. And so when you see Black people doing things, you need to support them wholeheartedly. You need to make sure that if they are not doing what's necessary, that you lovingly correct them in a way that's firm but honest, you know, so that we can build. And nobody's above correction, not even me. So you need to get to a place where you are fully engulfed in the atmosphere of your people who are doing the right things. There is a group full of Black excellence called Black CEO, you know, and you need to be involved. You need to get in. You need to make sure that you are posting, that you have your avatar, your special profile pics, you know, that you're coming to the conferences, that you are attending the live events, having these conversations, or I like to call them comma sessions. That's what my coach calls them comma sessions, because you're talking about them commas, you know, and we need to start utilizing our resources and making sure that we make things happen and we get together and we start really looking to dominate. Stop trying to compete. Focus on domination and everything else will fall into place.
Everything else will fall right in place. And you just heard from none other than D. Dave Anderson. This is not his last time on. He will be right back here again. I just really, really, really can't wait. We're going to have an awesome time. Make sure you get the book. What's the book again? Pitch, Sales, Close, and Repeat by Dave Anderson. He gave you the bit.ly to go to, which was bit.ly/join. To join the bully. I put it right there. There it is. To join the actual bully man. He is here. He gave of his gift. He gave of his time. He will be back again. He and I will talk. We're going to make sure that we bring in not only the best ideas, not only the best systems, not only the best structure, but we bring you the content that you can walk away and use. And for some of you, it's trainer content, right? You can take exactly what you learned and apply it in your business, but then you can also share it with someone else. You can pay it forward. So for all the folks that are out there, thank you so much for, number one, paying it forward. Thank you for sharing the video. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for taking time out today, because without you, there is no us. And Black CEO is not Dave Anderson. Black CEO is not Shay Brown. Black CEO is you. Whether you're CEO of your life, a CEO of your family, CEO of your business, a CEO of your community, every single day you are the CEO, and you are a Black CEO, and we recognize you, we honor you, we respect you. Continue to do what you're doing right now, because you're just a bad mamma jamma. You've got so much greatness, and you're wonderful, you're amazing, you're awesome. I want you to know that from the bottom of my heart and from the bottom of Dave Anderson's heart and from Trevor Otts, who's not on here right now. He's out somewhere getting his do-all up, by the way, Dave. So he's not on the call right now, but from everyone at Black CEO. And we close out, we always like to close out by saying Black CEO out, right? That's how we like to close. Black CEO out. So as you get ready to close out right now, look right below, and just type the words hashtag Black CEO and then out. That's a separate word. Hashtag Black CEO out. So we're going to close out. We're going to end this broadcast, this one Black, from one Black CEO to another conversation, with hashtag Black CEO out until we meet again. With that being said, my name, by the way, is Shay Brown, the sales cardiologist. You heard from none other than Dave Anderson, the business bully. You out there right now, you make it a great day. I want you to know that there's three things that I want you to continue to focus on. Three things. Jot these three things down. You know, they're so important, but just three things. Number one, stay humble. Always be willing to learn. That means that people walk over you, but you're willing to learn. You're open to new ideas. You're open to hearing something that maybe you didn't know before, but guess what? You're willing to do it right now. So stay humble. Be willing to serve. Be willing to help. If that's you as a Black CEO, I promise you, just do that alone and you come from a place of service, I promise you, you're going to help more people. You're going to generate more income and you're going to make a bigger difference in the world. So number one is what? Stay what? Humble. Someone jot that down right below. Stay humble. Number two, I want you to do this. Number two, pay close attention. Stay hungry. Always be willing to learn. Always be willing to invest in yourself. Always be thinking about, how can I do this bigger? How can I do it better? How can I raise my standard? What does that mean? Well, I raise my standard in my appointment setting. I raise my standard with my family. I spend more time with them. I raise my standard in my health. I take care of who I am and what I have. So I have the energy to do the things I want. See, first you got to stay humble. Then I want you to stay hungry. And then last, I want you to always hustle. I remember when I was working with Willie Jolly. Someone write that down. Stay humble, stay hungry. The last one is, you got to hustle. Willie Jolly, one of the baddest speakers on the planet. He's right here, local guy, Washington, D.C. Wrote the book, A Setup is a Setback for a Comeback. I remember I was talking to Willie Jolly. I was giving my first talk ever, by the way. It was at a university here in Washington, D.C. I called Willie Jolly up. It was about 11:30 going on 12 o'clock at night. I didn't expect to get the guy. I expected really to get what? A voicemail. But he popped on. It's a great day. And I knew right away it was none other than the, but not A, but the Willie Jolly, right? So I had the Willie Jolly on there. So as soon as Willie Jolly popped on, I asked him the question. I said, look, I'm getting ready to go give this talk. I'm getting ready to speak. What do you recommend I say? It was my first talk. I didn't know what to do. I mean, I read all the books. I'd written a lot of stuff, but you know, I had to talk to the expert, the person who's in the Speaker Hall of Fame, the person who's voted one of the top five speakers in the world. He has his own XM radio. He's had his own TV show. He's a singer. I mean, he's a speaker. He gets paid $20,000+. He travels the world. What should I say? Willie John said, Shay Brown, give him one word. And I said, oh, God, one word. You know what that word is? I'm thinking to myself, if I knew what the word was, I wouldn't be calling you at midnight. He said, the word is hustle, Shay. You tell them they got to hustle every moment of every minute of every day. They got to hustle. They got to give it everything they got. I'm not saying they got to work hard and not smart. I'm saying they got to hustle. You got to hustle every day. Like this is your first day as an entrepreneur. That's how I've been in business, Shay. I never slow down. I hustle. Doesn't mean he works hard. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is he takes every opportunity as if it's his first opportunity, he may never be back again. So first you got to stay humble. Then you got to stay what? Hungry. And then you got to hustle your butt off. You do that. And I promise you the best is yet to come. The best I promise you is yet to come. So as you're out there right now, Dave, I always tell him we like to close out by saying hashtag Black CEO out. So I'm going to ask Dave to say hashtag Black CEO out. As you sign off, you can type right below hashtag Black CEO what? Out. Dave, over to you, man.
Yeah, man. Hashtag Black CEO out, man. I'm so happy that everybody came through here.
All right. My name, by the way, is Shay Brown, the sales cardiologist. Hashtag Black CEO what? Out. We'll see you soon. God bless. Bye-bye.